Hey, you folks. All right. Well, welcome back to another broadcast of Live with the Shaman. And tonight is essentially, other than the review next weekend, our last evening of past life regression, also known as PLR. Well, what have we talked about? We've talked about past life regression, what it is, how it works, how to achieve it, and what it can do for us. Now, this evening you'll notice that I have the adult warning, or TVMA, if you will, on part 4 of past life regression. This evening we're going to be talking about the field of hands. And depending on whether or not anybody joins me live, will depend on how big of a discussion we have, and of course how long our broadcast is. Of course, the more people we have, the more interaction we have, the better and more interactive these broadcasts are. Otherwise, I'm sitting here talking to myself, which is fine. Some people say I like to hear my own voice. Not really. I like talking to people. I like interacting with people. And I've studied for a very long time this thing called the human animal. And this is what we are. The sexuality of the human animal is has to be a very balanced situation. And the reason I started using the field of hands way back when I started doing past life regressions is it allows the client, the individual, to have a place to relax. As you're going back through meditation and you've kind of covered this lifetime in your past life regression, as we talked about in prior broadcast, you get tense and you get excited and you begin to lose focus on what it is you're doing. And as I've said before, past life regressions are what you make of them. You have to be aware that there is no science in past life regressions. Past life regressions don't work for everyone. Luckily, everyone that I've ever taken back on a past life regression has done well. Some have done better than others. Some took them a bit. A lot got stuck in this lifetime. They couldn't seem to get past this lifetime. And that makes it tough. How do you do that? You do it through acceptance, relaxation. You do it through the understanding that you can't have any misconceptions. You can't have any serious expectations of what to come out through a past life regression. I don't, I haven't, and I won't charge people for a past life regression. Donations are fine. But what is this field of hands? Again, this is an adult topic, right? Keep that in mind. The field of hands is exactly what it says it is. It's a very comfortable feel with a very comfortable mat. And the field of hands can be used in basic meditation. astral travel and past life regressions. It is a resting place, a stopping point, a place to relax in your traveling through your PLRs, so to speak. The quick, easy way to access the field of hands is take yourself back through meditation. Put yourself in a field of flowers that you're not allergic to, on a comfortable pallet. Birds are singing, the sun is warm, but it's not too hot. If you like a cool breeze, put a cool breeze in there. This is your world. What you put in it is up to you at this point. Now, in using the feel of hand as a relaxation technique in past life regression, it allows you to be able to, like I say, relax, to receive a massage. Now, a spiritual massage is unlike anything you will ever experience in your life. It's amazing. The feel of hands is just that. It's when you lay down on this mat, on this pallet, and you relax. You either lay on your stomach or on your back. It doesn't matter. I recommend that you lay on your back. Okay? I have found the best reactions and interaction to come when the client's laying on their back. But it starts with a massage, very relaxing, and this is all done in the mind's eye. You put yourself on the pallet and you're relaxing in the sunshine with the birds singing, the cool breeze. And as you feel the breeze blowing across your body, you begin to feel the field itself coming alive. Don't let it freak you out. It's not going to snatch you like the body snatcher does. But what it's going to do, it's going to very calmly relax you. It's going to give you a massage. It's going to relax you. The energy is going to vibrate. It's going to hum. Now, I can tell you that 99% of the time, the massage does go sexual or tantric. Whichever phrase makes you comfortable. They're both the same. They both end up dealing with sexuality. Oh my God, there's that word, sexuality. Oh my. Fuzzy old shaman's talking about sex again. Again, still some more. Because it's what we are as human beings. Whether we're into asexual, that's fine. Heterosexual, bisexual, homosexual, or pansexual. All the other sexuals out there, it doesn't matter. The field of hands is there to pleasure and relax and help you along your way. Do you have to have it for past life regression? Absolutely not. Do you have to have it for astral travel? Absolutely not. Is it nice? Absolutely yes. Is it something I recommend you experience? Hell yes. You can experience the field of hands through meditation at any time. The reason I bring up the field of hands, I bring it up in astral travel, and I bring it up in past life regressions, because it is a part of my philosophy of past life regressions to be able to have a resting point, a resting place where you can get a massage from the field of hands. I don't touch you. I never lay a hand on you. The video and the audio will prove that on the recordings and such that I do of your PLR, should you decide. How long it takes is up to you. How much you enjoy it, that's up to you. There's no expectations one way or the other. The guide that I do in the PLR, in the field of hands, is suggesting and making the suggestion of the relaxation. relaxing on the pallet in a field under the sun, warm with a cool breeze. What you do with it, it's up to you. I'm not going to tell you. Not my job. Not my place. But wherever you decide to go with it, you're safe. You're in the safe surroundings. You're in a comfortable area, which is comfortable for you. I have had numerous clients that have gone into full sexual ecstasy while in the field of hands. I've had a few clients that when I'm discussing everything with them up front, they say, no, I'm not comfortable with that. I want to bypass that. Okay, fine. No problem. It's not a requirement. It's a suggestion. So what good is a PLR? Well, a PLR, past life regression, like I've said in the previous chapters, can take you back and show you who you were in past lifetimes. Can also help you deal with healing and getting through this lifetime. What the feel of hands does for you is help you relax. It's a bit of a break. Some want to start out in the field of hands. Okay, fine. I've had a number of clients that when we start going back through the meditation into the regression, they want to start out with the field of hands so that they can slide into that regression more relaxed, calmer, if you will. When you are working with, speaking to, or speaking with the element number 5, sexuality. Personality number 3, the adult. When you're working with and speaking with these elements and these personalities of the human, the object is to help you find that balance. Find that balance of the 5 elements and the 3 personalities. In doing so, it allows you to be able to slide deeper and deeper into that regression. It's not just a single thing that happens in a regression. It requires perfect timing and perfect balance of all parts of the human being. It requires a practitioner that understands exactly what they're doing, can watch the client for signs of distress, anxieties, anger, fear, can pick up on the energies, cold sweats, hot sweats, shivering, maybe too cold, maybe you need to cover your client up. That's fine. Whatever you need, whatever you have to do during a regression, you need to be sure that you are comfortable in your regression because it's for you. Especially nowadays with society as completely screwed up as it is, so many people have lost complete and total touch with their sexuality. And in some cases, the field of hands in the regressionary method can help you regain touch to that sexual self. A lot of times, new clients that are brought to me for healing, for counsel, maybe they've been through some very traumatic experience where pieces and parts of their bodies may have been destroyed and they no longer find themselves attractive. I mean, come on, I've been shot at and missed and shit at and hit and got broken fingers and busted toes, and my poor nose has been broken more times than I care to remember from when I was younger and dumber and would rather put them up rather than I would try to talk my way out of it. But these are the things that we live through that we experience that do cause emotional, psychological problems with the way we view our sexual self. Because if we don't like our physical self, how in the hell can we like our physical, our sexual self? Kind of what came first, the chicken or the egg? So where to from here? Well, the field of hands, like I say, can be accessed from anywhere at any time. They can be accessed by anyone for any reason, whether it's just simple relaxation, whether it's fantasy, right? Use for PLR, use for relaxation in the astral. The astral has an amazing feel of hands. It's a little different from the past life regression feel of hands, but it's still there nonetheless. The astral has an entire forest devoted to nothing but sexual pleasure. Yeah, figure that one out. And on a side note, if you've watched my astral travel videos and you've met with your guide in the astral, ask them to show you the forest of sexuality. It's called the forest of sexuality. It's a wonderful place. I'll admit, I spend a lot of time there. Nice place. And it's really a nice place when physical components of an aging body no longer work right. Right? Seeing as how we know through science that most of sexual pleasure comes from here. And it's the same way in the field of hands. If you can relax the mind and feel the body, let the body do what it does naturally. Let things happen the way the natural human body wants them to happen. Remove the mind from the equation and let the body do what it needs to do. What's screwed up? We're 18 minutes past the hour, and there really is nothing else I can come up about the field of hands. It can appear the way you want it to appear. It can react the way you want it to react. And it can do for you the things that you want it to do for you. If nothing but a simple massage, I've had a few that want just a simple massage, head to toe. Relax them like a bowl of jelly. I've had some, like I said, that wanted to just completely go into a complete and utter mind-blowing sexual abyss, to just essentially shut the mind and the body down, to open the psyche so that they can see the rest of their past life regression. And then some have opted out completely. Your past life regression is just that. It's yours. How you work it, what you do with it, how you do it, how you achieve it is up to you. So it looks to me like that when you're talking about the field of hands, I've had people ask me, Don, how does it work? Well, like I said in the beginning of the video, it is for you. It is an area for you, for relaxation, for whatever form of relaxation that you're looking forward to in your past life regression. So with this, like I say, we're 20 minutes past the hour. We've said about all we can for past life regressions. We've said about all we can for the field of hands. Next week, I'd like to go through a review. So any of you that watch our pre-recorded programs, I'd like to see you here next week at 8 p.m. Central Time here on Live with the Shaman. And I'd like for you to watch the other videos, the other parts to Live with the Shaman. Jot down your questions and let's talk about them. Thanks again for watching Live with the Shaman, and we see you next week right here.